Hi friends, good evening. This is Nagarajan from Phoenix Academy. As many of you requested, I am just making a video in English regarding the Profit Machine Robot Trader Dynamic Trader software. I have made one PDF file in English and one video. Okay, so both of that you can find it in my website under pnxacademy.com download HTML. When you click this download, you will find all the details here. Under the head of Profit Machine Dynamic Trader, you will find Dynamic Trader software, user manual English, and video guide English. Okay, now we'll go there. See, I have given all the details about the software, the product name, version, file size, operating system, system requirement, and the minimum internet speed required. And the key features of the software I have mentioned here, just please read it. And for demo purpose, what you have to do, just visit www.pnxacademy.com and click on downloads. Just go to pnxacademy.com and click on downloads. So the page will be open. On the left part you will find it is a Profit Machine Signal software. It is a manual trading software. On the right part you will see Profit Machine Dynamic Trader. It is a robot trading, fully automated robot trading. You will find the Dynamic Trader Robo software here. You can just download it by clicking this one. Just watch it. When you click, automatically the download will start. I'll just pause it. Okay. And user manual in English. When you click this, automatically the user manual will be opened here. And the video guide, when you click this, a YouTube video will be opened and you can watch it. Okay. Now, for best understanding, watch the video also. Okay. Okay, so for demo, we will continue. Visit our website, click on downloads, download the software and install. So once the installation on the last phase, it will ask you whether to launch the application or not. Don't launch the application. That means don't run the application, just close the installation. That's it. After that, your software will be installed like this. See, it is Profit Machine DT. Just right click on the software and go to properties. Right click on the software and go to the properties. Another window will be opened. In that window, just click on the compatibility. On the compatibility, select run this program as an administrator. Just select it and click OK. That's it. Now it's ready. Now you can open it. Okay. So the software will be opened like this. See, so set the property to run as administrator and open the robo. Once open, it will ask you for the registration. First time when you are opening, first time it will ask you for the registration. Just to register the product. After registration, inform us at our WhatsApp number. So this is our WhatsApp number. When you message us, our technical team will activate the product and provide you the required demo. Okay. So you have to give us some time. Okay. So once your product is activated, you can get the login access and you can just enter your login ID and your password, whatever you have generated, that enter here and just click login. Your product will be opened. So once the product is opened, first thing we have to do the settings. Okay. So what are the settings? First setting is do the below settings in robot section. Where is the settings? Okay. Here it is. This is the software. Okay. Just go to here. Robo trade settings, or you can find it here, options, robot settings. In both way you can open the robot settings. First thing, as mentioned here, see, everything is mentioned here. You have to do product type, you have to select MAS, order type, you have to select market, and in money management, per order profit, select percentage and put 0.5. don't select to do anything on the risk, on the net risk also. Just select this option, net profit, and put whatever amount you want, 5,000, 10,000, 15,000, whatever you want. On the right side, don't do anything, just leave as it is. Okay, now we will go here. Just here, product type, MIS, market type, market, that means order type, market. These are all settings you have to do. Again, you have to come here. Integration settings. Integration means integration with your terminal. Okay, so trading terminal integration, just choose Nest Trader. After that, you have to click on this button to select the trading terminal path. Just click here. If you have selected Nest Trader, automatically the software will find the Nest path and go here. Just click double click. The next application will be shown here. Just click on this one. That's it. So the version number will be shown. Once you set the path, automatically the version number will be shown here. Now you have to verify with your version. See 3.16.0.4. Now open your Nest. You just check here. But here it is showing 3.16.0. So what you have to do here? 3.16.0. So the remaining part you just delete it. That's it. Okay. Next, data from MarketWatch property, set no. Okay, there are two options, but set no. That's it. Okay. And click apply. Upright. And now go to the orders tab. In the orders tab on the left side, don't do anything. On the right side, you can see when order target was not reached. That means if stop loss hit, what you have to do? You can increase your lot size. So you can do like this one. If you put one, what it will do? If it has taken a buy, if stop loss hit, then it will go for a sell order with one lot. But if you put two or three or whatever, if one lot in buy, if stop loss hits, automatically it will go with two lots. It will close the buy order and it will take two lots in sell order. So what will happen by the end of the day? It will cover all the losses and end with profit. Okay. And we want set maximum number of increases. So how many times you want to increase your lot sizes, that you can specify here. Normally in default it is disabled. If you want to set like first order one quantity and next order two quantity and third order four quantity or fifth order, like that you can set. If you set here some 3 means, what it will happen? It will go with 1, 2, 4. If you set 4 means 1, 2, 4, 8. But just don't do this, just disable it. Okay. And this one is very important. Stop trading when order target has reached. When the order target, whatever you said, is reached, automatically it will stop the trading for the entire day, because you already reached your target. So no need of trading the whole day. Okay. So this is all you have to do. Then again click apply. That's it. Now come to the time tab. Here NSE trading you just set 9:26, MCX timing set 11 o'clock, and automatic closing of the trades set 3:15 for NSE and MCX 11 o'clock. That's it. So these are the settings you have to do. Just click apply, come out. Okay. Okay. So do the glow settings in robotics section, and again chart settings. What are the chart settings you have to do before opening the charts? Come here, go to options, click on charts. Let's just close this. That mistake I opened. Okay, in the orders, chart section, on the properties, go to the volume panel, click on hide, okay, and come to the grid pan. Just these all will be selected, but don't do these all. Just select only open grid, untick all this. Only two things you have to tick: open grid and price line. Just click apply. That's it. Okay. So now you are ready for chart settings. So now the chart settings done. Now strategy setting. Whatever strategy products you are going to run, you have to choose a strategy. Okay. Okay. Now we will go to the chart. This chart I will explain you how to open it all. Okay. Now right click on the chart. You will find buy and sell strategy. Just click on dynamic trading. This is your strategy. So I mentioned here dynamic strategy. So on the chart, right click, select buy sell strategy, and then select dynamic trading. Okay, this is your strategy. And for live trading, you have to do some settings in the Nest Trader. Okay, for live trading, do the glow settings in Nest Trader. What you have to do first, just log in to your Nest. It is login already. Go to the preference menu, then click user settings. On the user settings, under the category of order, under exchange segment, select all. Under the default values, product type MIS, order type market, then set number of market lots 1. Just tick this one, okay, and focus on order quantity. Select this one, not this one, this one. And there will be so many selections like this. Don't do this. Just untick all. You have to do only single click to place order and close order entry dialog after placing order. That's it. Just click OK. After doing all this, just click OK. Okay, so this is done. So I have mentioned all this here. In the order category, do the settings as mentioned above and open the order book. You can use F3 or menu to open the order book. See here, you can see the menu, or you can use F3 button. So this order book will be opened. See, normally this will be not ticked. Display all orders. We have to select it. And after this, you just come bottom on the complete orders. You just keep your mouse on the header of this header, right click and reposition columns. On the reposition columns, I have set everything already, but what you want to do is, see, as mentioned here, see, trading symbol, average price, order type, product type and exchange timestamp should be available in this right pane. Okay, so what I will do, see, exchange update time, select here and click on this button, it will come here, and product type. See, product type, order type, these all already available here. So trading symbol, exchange update time, product type, order type and average price. Average price, these all should be available. Once you have transferred all from here to here, just click on save. That's it, your next settings is done. So once you've done this, all are ready, you can go for live trading. But before moving to live trading, please make it sure, without enough demo practice, don't enter into live trade. Because if you are doing any work without practice, without knowledge, without experience, you may end with loss. Okay, please take care. And what are the other things you have to check in the robo? Market watch is the main area. See, in market watch, same like your Nest terminal, you will find all the products here. What we are having in the market watch, see, we provide you stock recommendation scanner. It will give you some equities, means equity scanner. It will give you some 20 products, the best products to trade on intraday today. Okay, and stock recommendations derivative means it will give you futures. And like that, you can have your favorites. Some products you can keep as favorites. In my favorite, what I kept, Apollo Hospital, Bajaj Finance, BEML, Biocon, India Browsing, Jubilee Food and Titan. Why I kept all this? Because the lot size is less. Apollo Hospital some 250, 500, 400 and maximum 700. So whenever the orders multiplies, if stop loss hits, the order will be multiplied, as I explained you. So that time, with less money, you can go with good profit. Okay, so that's why I have kept these all products under my favorite. Okay, so these are my favorite products. I set it in the market watch. So how to set it? Go to load from groups. Here you will find all feature and option, all MCX and different category. You will find the cash products and here your favorites. You can set your favorite. Even you can write your name, my favorite. Like that, you can just add here. See, my favorite is here. And Apollo Hospital, Bank Nifty, Jubilee Food and Titan is already here. You can just delete all the product by pressing the delete button. Okay. And even you can add the products. NSE, you can add NFO, MCX. NFO, I'm just adding a product. See, I'm adding Apollo Hospital. Okay. Just choose a plus button, add script, it will be added here and choose save. That's it. So if I go here and right click, load from groups, I choose my favorite, export to market watch. So it will be coming here. Okay. So what you have to do, see, in the stock in the market watch, I have given stock recommendations on cash market and come feature. And on load, next is favorite settings. You have seen, you can do the favorite settings here. Go here, favorites, we can add. How you can add? Click on load products. On the favorites, you can add whatever products you need. Just click on the favorites and whatever products you need, you can just add it, save. So that will be shown here. When you click the favorites, automatically all the products whichever you selected will come here. Okay. And next thing is load groups and load charts, stock panel. Okay. See, for individual stocks, if you want to add, just click on this individual products. Okay. When you go here, automatically it will be shown. What are, for example, if you need crude oil, just go to crude oil, just click on this. That's it. You can see like this, okay. And any other products if you want to do, just go to load from groups, whatever products you want. See, I want cash market only FMCG product or finance products. Just click on this, go to export to market watch, all the products will be shown here, okay. You have seen it, right? Okay, how to open a new chart? Just go here, select the product, whichever product you want. For example, okay, you need ICICI Bank. Just click on the ICICI Bank, right click, load ICICI Bank chart. So that chart will be opened. Okay, so that chart will be opened. That's it. Okay, that very shortcut, you can go to stock panel and right click the same ICICI Bank. You can select here or Axis Bank. Okay, Axis Bank equity here, Axis Bank feature here. Okay, you need Axis Bank feature and right click on that product and load Axis Bank chart. Automatically it will be opened here. See, it is opening. That's it. Okay. And the main thing is, what is the time frame we have to keep? Just select 15 minutes, okay? Always use 15 minutes for better performance. Just click on 15 minutes, okay? How to do with all products? So before opening the chart, if you select 15 minutes, whatever the chart opens, it will go with 15 minutes. Okay, if you find any difference, just right click on the chart, go to chart period, select 15 minutes. That's it, okay? Next, the important thing what we have to do is, okay, now if you want to close this chart, what you have to do, don't go and keep this one. If you click this one, the chart will be open but hidden. So what you have to do, if you want to close all this chart, just go to window, close all charts, all the charts will be closed. That's it, see. You will find the information here. 9 charts closed. And if you want to open a chart, go to any product, order product you want, just click on the product, right click and load ICICI Bank chart. It will be open. Okay, if you want to close the individual chart, what you have to do? Right click, then close this. Don't use this corner, this X button. Okay. Just click on the close chart here. Automatically it will ask a confirmation message. When you click it, it will be closed. Right? That's it. Okay, so next part is in order manager, what you have to see. Okay, what I am going to do, I will select my favorite product. Here I have selected my favorite product. If I want to select all this product in a single shot, just load all chart. All the charts will be loaded. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 charts loaded. Okay, I don't need ACC. So just I will select the ACC, right click and close chart. That's it. Okay, now what I have, 2, 4, 6 products I have. 6 products I have. You should keep enough money, okay? Don't forget that. If you don't keep enough money and opening too many charts, then you may end with problem because your NIST will reject the orders immediately, okay? So I have opened all the products. So once you open these products, so if you want to just see all the things very clear, just you can move the pans, okay, you can just like this you can do. See, just go to order manager, whatever charts you have opened here, that will be shown in this section and it will give you the quantity size also. In future it will give you the quantity size. Okay, now you want to go with India Food Housing 2 lots, so what you have to do, just go here and select 800 means it is 2 lots, so you can set the quantity also here. So the main thing in this is order manager. Under order manager you will find a header trade manager. In the trade manager you will see all the products whichever you selected, what is the strike price, what is the quantity. Once order taken, it will show you the price, entry price, the target and stop loss, everything here. Individually you can start the robo or all at a time you can do it. Okay, then what is the order book? Order book means once your order is executed, it will show you the details of the particular order. When the order is triggered, at what price, whether buy or sell, everything you can see here. Then net position means whatever orders are running currently, that will be shown here. Okay. And profit loss report means whatever orders closed with the profit or loss, that will be shown here. Okay. And this message events means whatever happens in the robo, that will be recorded here. Whatever, any disconnection or slow or broadcast disconnected, whatever happens, that will be recorded here. An auction watch like this, whatever buy sell signals or any recommendations, that will be shown in the auction watch. Then order manager will know, okay. And money management. In money management section, we already showed. See, in the robo setting, you will find money management. You have to select 0.5% per order risk. No need. Net profit you can select, you can enter as you wish, and net risk no need to set, okay, and apply. So NSE 0.5 is the common, and for MCX go with copper and zinc. For copper and zinc, instead of 0.5%, enter 0.25%, okay, because the copper and zinc rate is higher and the movement also less. So go with 0.25%. The maximum we can go is 0.4%, okay. And for live trading, keep enough money to take all the orders, else orders may get rejected and you may end with loss. So this you have to keep in your mind. And what are the disadvantages you are having with the robo? In sideways market, it may make loss. Sometimes we faced some losses, okay. If any data issue or server issue, the system may end with loss. See, sometimes even the exchange gets some server issue. Last month, if you see on MCX exchange, I think 4 times the server is down. The trading was halted for minimum to 30 minutes to 2 hours. So many people ended with loss. So you have to be careful on this. And you have to provide uninterrupted internet and power supply for the smooth running of robo trading. For this, we recommend VPS, virtual private server. And apart from this, if you do over trading, definitely it may end with huge profit or loss. Even you may earn lakhs and lakhs in a day, or you may lose your entire money. So never do over trading. Just keep in your mind, the market is running the whole year. Don't think in a single day you want to earn the, you want to catch the entire trend, or you want to catch entire money whatever you lost. Don't do that, okay, please. Even if you are earning 1,000 rupees to 2,000, 3,000 per day, it is a very good profit. Whenever your profit is done, don't do again, okay. That's why we have given the option here. Whenever your profit is done, it will stop the trading, okay. So never do over trading, please, okay. And for more technical support, or if you are having any issues with installation and connection with your system, just call your technical support team at 951400-1400, and okay. A final thing is, you have done all the settings, everything, how to connect with your Nest, okay. We have done the settings in the Nest and you have done the settings in robo. Now how to connect with your Nest terminal? Just go here, see this button, robotic trading or backtest. Backtest means you can check your strategy, how was the result, but this is not yet enabled, it will take some time. Just select, if you set backtest, it will be in yellow color. If you select robotic trading, it will be in red color. So select robotic trading, and the next button, if you select manual trading, it will be in yellow color. Just select automatic trading system, it will be in green color. So first should be in red, next should be in green. So you have set the system. Now come to the bottom. If you see here, trade terminal disconnected now. So you have to connect. Just connect it. Are you sure to connect Nest Trader account? Yes. Trading service has been started successfully. This message will come. Once this message comes, means it is already connected with the Nest Trader. Okay. Now come to the order, trade manager. You will find all the products whatever you have opened here. If you want to run only a single product, just click on that particular product, click start. See, all the remainings are in red color and this is in green with right mark. That means the robo has started its work. If you want to start all the products, just click start all. If you want to stop all products, just click stop all. Okay. So I click start all. See, once you've done this, the automatically whenever there is a signal, the robot will place the orders, targets, stop loss, trailing stop loss, everything our robot will take care. Okay. Okay. In meantime, you want to do a manual trade. For an example, I want to buy it now. Apollo market is sell. I just missed the sell signal, so I want to just sell it. Just click the sell. It will show you the price and everything. Just click on submit. Order request successfully. If you see on the order book. If you go here, okay, today market is not is under valid market protection. Okay, so the market is not available, server is not available, so it won't send you the product. Okay, order waiting for confirmation. See, order request successfully, order waiting for pending, because today is Sunday, so no market is available, it won't send the orders. Okay, if you see, please under valid market protection, everything the message will come again and again, because it is not open, the market is not open. Okay, so you can see all the messages in this, and whatever my errors, everything will be here. See, waiting for response, sell Apollo, requested to send Apollo, transaction process not required for first time order ending, rejected and Apollo by robot system, no orders will be executed. That's it. So if you see on the order book, what it will do, it will try three times. If any problems arise in your Nest Trader, automatically what it will do, it will just put the particular product in gray color. You see, it will put the particular product in gray color and it will stop the robo. Just check here. It will again don't do on that particular product. If you want to do it, just you have to do it again. You have to start the robo. Okay. If you see any product with this dark gray color, means that product is disabled by the robo, because the Nest has rejected more than three times, so it will never try again. If you want to try again, you have to just go here, right click and start. Okay, that's it. I think we have explained all. You have to connect with this. Okay, once the order is done, you just go here. You can select the target and stop loss here also. Okay, see, I told you for MCX you can enter 0.25, so you can just set the 0.25 here. So whenever the order taken, automatically it will go with this order. But when you set here in the money management, it is a universal target and stop loss. Universal means when you set here, automatically it will be applied to all the products whichever available in the trade manager. Okay. But if you want to change any target or stop loss manually, you can go here and you can do the changes here. So whenever you do any changes here, the first thing will happen from this target and stop loss only. It won't look for the universal settings. It will look for the local settings, these settings. Okay. So whatever available here, that will the system will take this target and stop loss. Okay. So these are the things we have to cover. I think almost I covered all the settings and connection settings and all. Okay. Okay. Have a profitable trading, and keep in your mind, please never over trade and never trade without any practice. So go with demo trading for the next 1 week. Learn all the things. Any error may happen because you are new to this system. Out of your interest, you may end with some loss. So do the trades in demo mode. Once you are happy, once you are familiar with the system, then go with live trade. Okay, thank you, all the best. Bye bye.